Attention.
Oh, hey, Montreal. I'm your host and best friend, Alex Melky. Now, I know you're thinking, Alex, orange you in front of the orange julep? Okay, that was a terrible joke, and I'm so sorry, but let me make it up to you with a kick-ass episode. Hit it! For decades, awesome people like you have been looking for a convenient way to get shit-faced while remaining very classy, a feat thought to be almost impossible until today. Ladies and gentlemen, wine-infused gelato has come to Montreal. And the only place you can get some is over at Gelateria Pierino. Which started off as a taste experiment with peach snaps and gelato turned into a delicious freak of science. The hardest part is gonna be choosing what flavor you wanna have your gelato injected with. I'm talking Jack Daniels, vodka cranberry, and beer. Yeah, it's time to get fancy crunk. You can get all the details at mtlblog.com. Big news this week is that cops all across Canada now have the right to go through your cell phone if you get arrested. According to the Supreme Court of Canada, a search can be warranted if it relates directly to your arrest. Privacy lawyer Chris Klein says cops already do a body search when they arrest someone, so going through your cell phone isn't all that different. Well, actually it is, Chris. You see, I don't keep thousands of naked pictures of myself in my pockets. I keep that on my iPhone. Now, I can't be the only person that takes this many naked pictures of myself. Give me a break. Now, going through the comments section of the article we posted, you guys have been throwing out tons of tips and tricks on how to have your phone's data disappear if a cop tries to go through it. Maybe you should try to just not get arrested. Or maybe this is a huge violation of privacy. And that leads us into this week's question of the week. Are cops just keeping up with the times by checking cell phones? Or is this seriously a violation of citizens' privacy? Let us know what you think in the comments below. Now, Fest 300 is a website that brings its readers all the important info on the best music festivals in the world. Recently, they held a pretty awesome contest where all readers had to do was vote on their favorite festival to win 2 tickets to any festival in the world. Now, cool part about this is that over 20,000 people voted. And while we didn't grab the number one spot, Montreal's Oceaga was voted the second greatest music festival in the world. Now, Oceaga was just 800 votes away from the number one spot. That's all good. It's not a big deal. There's always next year. Just one more thing that makes Montreal fucking awesome. Every week at mtlblog.com, I go through all your Instagram pictures, looking for cool pictures of Montreal. Now, this week, there were a lot of great submissions. But Instagrammer hm.pics killed it with this amazing shot overlooking Montreal. So, check out hm.pics' account and follow mtlblog's Instagram account. So that's going to be it for this week's episode of Anchorman MTL. Make sure to share, like, and subscribe for updates about Montreal that you actually care about. And check out mtlblog.com for 25 Montreal New Year's Eve parties to ring in 2015, the 9 best shishtewed places in downtown Montreal, the best Montreal stores to find the perfect ugly sweater, and the latest and greatest of what this city has to offer. Now I'm off to have an impromptu photo shoot with the orange julep. I'll see you next week, Montreal.
Get into it, live with your back.
Gotta get my vitamin C.